Yeah, must be great, huh, Charlie? World famous astronaut, idol to millions, houses all over the world, beautiful women. Hey, wait a minute. You're not an astronaut, you're an accountant. One house, one wife, two kids, and no future. And today you turn 40 years old. Your nightmare begins when you open your eyes. You live in hell. Oh, oh, oh! But from now on, he's gonna have to!
Listen, don't make a big deal about your father's birthday. He's a little upset about turning 40.
No, when my friend's father turned 40, he tried to hang himself. Because I shouldn't get him that tie.
Oh, no. I bought him soap on a rope.
Warren! Wyatt! Ever since we had that dog fixed, he won't listen to anyone. Oh, my God, this is hot. Here, honey, have some decaf.
Oh, God, decaf.
Dad, can I have $20 to buy you a new birthday present?
Look, I don't want your blood on my hands.
Thanks.
Dad, I'm thinking about having sex. I just thought you should know.
What?
Yeah, just failing biology. I thought that'd take the sting out of it.
Sweetheart, I've got to go. Charlie, give me some money. I need to get a manicure for my interview at Cufflink City. There's a sales job open, and I think this could be my stepping stone. Thank you very much. Bye, sweetheart.
Happy birthday, Dad. You're the bestest daddy in the whole darn world. Oh, happy birthday, sweetheart. I love you. Big, wet, sloppy kiss. Hugs from my loving children. Oh, and good luck on your promotion today, honey. I just know you're gonna get it.
Charlie, could you walk Warren? I think he has to go.
Too late.
Morning, Doris.
Morning, Mr. Hoover. Happy birthday, Mr. Hoover.
Thank you, Doris.
Oh! Mr. Hoover!
Oh.
Oh! Mr. Hoover, I am so sorry. Are you all right?
Well, it's just my head.
Oh, good. I mean, oh, good that you're not hurt, not oh, good, like your head isn't important or something like that. I mean, like, you know what I mean. Oh! Mr. Culberton's office called. He's gonna see you right away. I'm just sure it's about your promotion. I just know you're going to get it this time.
Thank you, Doris.
Mr. Hoover, you're wearing sneakers.
Oh, the dog peed on my shoes.
Oh, that always happens.
To you, too?
No, just to you. Good luck.
Mr. Culberton? Mr. Culberton? It's Charlie Hoover.
Ah, Hoover. You wanted to see me?
Yes, sir, I did.
Anything else? Sit down.
It's about my promotion.
Hoover, you're wearing sneakers.
There was an accident.
Accident? Anybody hurt?
Just wet.
Thank goodness. Still a brush with death. Must make you wonder what life's all about. I know it does me. Good day, Hoover.
It's cold. Mr. Culberton.
There's more.
Yes, sir. You've been promising me that vice presidency.
Question?
For the
Did I sign anything?
Well, no.
Always get it in writing, Hoover. A man's word is his bond, but not if it isn't in writing. Hoover! You have been with this company for 5 years.
9.
And in those 8 years, your work here has been A1, tip-top. Unfortunately, we're smack dab in the middle of this darn recession. And in a recession, things recess. That is, they go backwards. Luckily for you, with everything else going backwards, you are actually moving forwards by standing still. Metaphysically speaking, you've actually gotten your promotion. Congratulations, Hoover.
I haven't actually gotten anything.
Ah, we're communicating. I like that. Good meeting. Keep up the good work, Hoover. I've got my eye on you.
This has been a lovely morning. Family ignores my birthday. Doris whacks me in the head with a door. Culberton, that maniac, cons me out of my promotion again. And it's not even lunchtime. This is great. And I'm 40. Life is supposed to begin at 40. This is not a very good beginning.
Oh, yeah, baby. Rub that lotion all over. Let's see. We got nude sunbathers, stewardesses, Swedish girls. Oh, yeah. We're having a good day here.
What the hell are you?
I'm Hugh.
You're me?
No. No. If I were you, I'd jump. Back off, grass eater! Get your binoculars! No, I'm Hugh. As in Hefner, I'm your alter ego. You know, like when you're walking down the street and a guy bumps into you and you go, excuse me, but that little voice inside you goes, oh, watch it, jerk! That's me.
Oh, God, I'm hallucinating. I turn 40 and I start hallucinating? I can't take this anymore!
Mr. Hoover, what are you doing? Have you gone crazy?
I think so.
Oh, rip her clothes off!
Get out of here!
Me?
No, him.
Who?
Hugh.
Me.
No, him.
I love this bit.
Just see him. He's a tiny little pervert about the size of the number 2 pencil, wearing a long coat and holding the binoculars.
Why, yes. Yes, he's right over here. Look at him. Oh, and he's just running over there. Hello, little mister.
Now, here's your little Mr. Doris.
Stop it. Stop it. Will you stop it?
Okay, Mr. Hoover. Let's sit down, shall we? Now, I know you're upset. Mr. Hoover, it's a terrible thing that you didn't get your promotion. Again. Now that you're 40, I'm sure you're taking stock of your entire life and wondering if maybe your whole career hasn't been a waste, and even if your whole life hasn't been a waste. I'll get you a tranquilizer. I have one in my purse. They'll help.
I'd go easy on those tranquilizers, Chuck. If you were tranquil, you'd be dead. Plus, I've heard rumors they can become habit for me.
Chuck, how the hell did I know my name? No, 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 don't answer that. You're not real. If you're real, I'm a very sick man. And if you're not real, I'm still a very sick man.
You see, it's like this, Chuck. I'm your alter ego. I'm your pleasure center. What you feel, I feel. The problem is, you're boring me into a coma. Do you know what it's like living inside you for the last 40 years? It's hell. It's one long, monotonous every day. It's the same as the one before it out. I mean, I know honest people having more fun than you.
That is not true. I lead an extremely satisfactory life.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Your job's a snore. Your family treats you like a cash machine. Your dog thinks you're a fire hydrant. Yeah, someone call Robin Leach. Let's do a photo session. And by the way, when's the last time you and Helen made this little noise, huh?
Hey, that is none of your damn business. Now, look, you, whoever you are or whatever you are, you just get the hell out of my office. You're not real, so I'm not listening to you anymore.
Oh, your nostrils flare when you get angry. That's good. You should use that on your boss.
Oh, yeah. And what, flare my nostrils?
No, get angry. Get mad. Knock down his door. Tear up his furniture. Get in his face. Tell him you want that promotion or else. For once, stand up and take some kind of control over your miserable life.
He'd fire me.
He'd fire me. He'd fire me. Oh, you're not even a man. Take off those clothes. Put on a dress. Where's your personal matching shoes? Where is it?
All right. I'll do it. I'll do whatever you say. As long as you promise me that you won't be here when I get back.
Deal.
Look at me. I'm bargaining with an hallucination.
Oh, hi, Doris. I was just dictating a memo. I'm gonna go get some air. Alone.
Great. I'll put these on your desk.
Yo, lovely.
Nice dress.
Wait, thank you.
Mr. Culberton.
What are you doing? Selling Girl Scout cookies? Come on, speak up!
What are you doing here?
Running a major corporation.
You promised you'd go away.
I was going on vacation to Barbados. How would you know that?
He thinks you're talking to him.
I know.
Don't worry, he can't see me.
Don't you shut up.
Oh, you are acting strangely. It must be from that accident.
There was no accident. My dog peed on my shoes.
I've had it. Just tell him that either you get that promotion or you quit. I mean, I'm trying to help you. Come on, tell him.
Look, Mr. Culberton, you've been promising me that promotion for 3 years now, and recession or no recession, either you give it to me right here and now, or I'll have no choice but to resign.
Hoover, not many people would have the courage to march in here and talk to me like that. That took guts. I like guts. Unfortunately, I hate ultimatums. You're fired.
What?
Fired?
Michael. Are these your hands?
Mm-hmm.
Son, is there a reason why you wear them?
Definitely.
Mm-hmm. Think Mom would like me in these?
Maybe.
Now try Hanes Activewear and Hanes Socks. Two more ways to look your best.
Nissan Maxima GXE. Pleasant dreams.
A lot of women find my looks intimidating. Do you?
My mother makes the best brisket.
There I was in the Congo.
Why is a good man so hard to find?
Just a minute, okay?
Why ask why? Try Bud Dry. It's dry brewed, not watered down. To drink light, yet satisfy completely. So while men aren't perfect,
you finish that?
At least refreshment is.
What do you give a blonde with no brains?
Hi, I'm Kelly.
Her own TV show.
The mind wobbles, doesn't it?
It's Kelly on Cable, Married with Children Sunday. Can Herman keep a secret?
I'm a virgin.
Don't bet on it.
This is Louise.
The virgin.
And all new Herman's Head.
No!
Sunday on Fox.
With the highest resale value in its class and proven Honda reliability, the Accord truly is a safe place to put your money.
This is going to be great. We're on unemployment. We'll kick back for 6 months. We'll sleep in. We'll hang out. I mean, we'll be able to do whatever you want.
Oh, no, it's back. Why don't you leave me alone, huh?
Just get out of here. Disappear. Shoot.
Oh, what's in that sandwich? My God, it stinks. Smells like someone crawled in between two pieces of bread and died.
Oh. You don't know. It's egg salad. My wife made it for me.
Ah, she must despise you.
God, Helen, she's gonna kill me.
The sandwich could be the murder weapon. Oh.
I'm gonna tell her I got fired.
How am I gonna tell her I'm fired? Oh, you're afraid of your wife?
I am not.
Oh, I blame the women's movement for this. God, I missed the 50s. Back then, a guy was a man. You know, he lost his job, he'd go home and say, honey, I lost my job. Bring me a beer.
Well, I can't do that.
Why? What's the worst she can do? Make you another sandwich?
Don't you forget about the sandwich. Don't you understand what is going on here? I am unemployed. I'm going to lose everything. My house, the cars, all our savings. And it's all your fault. Just go away.
Can't do that, Chuck. I mean, yeah, you're having a midlife crisis. I'm it. Slow down. Smell these roses instead of that sandwich. Come on, you must have always had a dream. Tell me your greatest dream. Come on. I want to hear every nasty, dirty, disgusting, raunchy detail. Come on. Tell me your dream. Let me hear it. Embarrass me. Come on.
I've always wanted a boat.
A goat? Oh, you're sick, man. A goat?
No, a boat.
Oh, a boat.
Ever since I was a kid, I've loved sailing. Yeah, you know, standing on the deck, sun in your face, the crisp, sweet smell of the ocean breeze as it sends you bounding out over the high seas without a care in the world. Oh, there's nothing like that feeling, you know? Nothing.
That's your dream, huh?
Am I kidding? I must be crazy. I'm never gonna get a boat. And why am I even talking to you? I'm going home to my family.
Why?
Because they love me.
Oh, come on. They were on the fence about you when you had a job.
I know my family a little bit better than you. Not only will they understand me, they'll rally around me. After all, it is my birthday.
Happy birthday, dear Charlie. Happy birthday to you.
Well, my family didn't take it very well.
Take it very well? Oh, I don't know. Helen made a list of every guy she could have married. The son took a swing at you. And then your little princess called up a lawyer to see if she could have you institutionalized.
He didn't do any of that.
I'll read between the lines. They wanted to.
You just don't understand the relationship I have with my family at all.
I understand it perfectly. The human cash machine is out of service, so they bailed on you. That's why we should do this. Tell Helen we're going out for a pack of butts.
Don't smoke.
A newspaper.
Too depressing.
A cup of joe.
No caffeine.
Tell them you're going out for some air. You breathe, don't you? Oh, what's the difference? You're gonna move to Canada. You're gonna be a lumberjack. Wield a mighty axe. Wear flannel shirts, woolly caps. Get drunk and arm wrestle till dawn with bearded guys named Fritchie and Jacques.
No. Tomorrow morning, I'm gonna march into Culberton's office and beg him for my old job back. I'll settle for that.
Settle? I've been settling with you for 40 years. You think I like being your alter ego? Hey, I could have had Elvis. Oh, yeah, during the fat years, but he was still the king. But no, instead, I get you. I can't take it anymore.
Better?
Yeah. Yeah, thank you. Look, Chuck, I just came back to put some fun in your life, but I get it. You've got responsibilities. But I just want to say one thing. This isn't batting practice. This is your life. You can either step up to the plate or sit on the bench and pick splinters out of your butt. It's your choice, Charlie. It's your choice.
Mr. Culberton, it's Charlie Hoover.
Question, Hoover. Didn't I fire you?
Yes, you did.
That's a relief. I thought I dreamt it. Well, if you've come to beg for your old job back, don't bother.
Oh, no.
You can have it.
I can.
Why not? Perhaps I was a bit hasty in firing you. Not wrong, mind you, merely hasty. It's that ultimatum business. It just raises the hairs on the back of my neck. But that's my problem, and I'm learning to deal with it. Okay, Hoover. Nice to have you on board again. Now, back to work.
No.
No?
No, look. I have worked at this company for 9 years. Not 5 years, not 8 years, but 9 years. And I deserve that vice presidency. So either you give it to me or I'll go work someplace else. Or maybe I'll just stay fired. Or maybe I'll just take off on a sailboat and go around the world. But either way, I am not going to spend another second of my life picking splinters out of my butt. And that is an ultimatum, whether you like it or not. I did it! Yes! Oh, I can't believe I actually did it.
You're beginning to frighten me.
Doris, I got my promotion!
Big raise! Big raise! Whoa! Oh, isn't life great?
Yes, I suppose so. You're making me so dizzy.
Oh, Doris, I'm sorry. I just got a little carried away.
No, that was fun. Oh, Mr. Hoover, I'm just so happy about your promotion and all.
Doris!
Yes?
Would you go call my wife?
Yeah, sure.
Ah, Inga, you Scandinavian vixen. Oh, I was like a man you could keep in your purse, huh, baby? Charlie, congratulations on that promotion, huh?
Yeah, it's great, isn't it? And thanks for all your help, because if it wasn't for you, I never would have gotten it.
My pleasure. Want to look at the stewardesses as they're waking up from the all-night pajama party?
Oh, I don't think so.
Oh, come on. Here, use my spare.
I'll just fade it.
Now, just adjust those little knobs on the inside. Have you seen something then?
No, I don't see.
Whoa!
Yeah. Which one is Inga?
She's the one in the pink baby doll nightie. Right out of a Bobby Darin movie, huh? Oh, the shark bites. Yeah! With his teeth, dear. Take it, shark. Doesn't know the song.
Wife's online, too.
Tell her I'll call her back.
Venture!
Well, I better get going. I guess this is goodbye.
Are you kidding? Come on. My work's just begun. It's a whole world waiting out there for us to go out and live out your wildest fantasies.
I don't have any wild fantasies.
Of course you do. I make them up.
You live them out.
Oh, man, you don't get it yet, do you? We need each other. I've got the fantasies, you've got the body and the cash. Wherever you go, I go. We're a team.
Well, I'm going to take the rest of the day off, so?
Great! We'll drain your bank account, we'll go to Atlantic City, there's girls, there's gambling.
Wait. I'm going to buy my boat.
We'll buy your boat. Then we'll drain your bank account and we'll sail to Atlantic City. There's gambling, there's girls.
I don't want gambling. I don't want girls. I want to buy my boat and go home and see my family.
Oh, them. Well, I guess we can go home, have a meal, watch TV. It'll be another thrill a minute, happy to be alive, pinch man must be dreaming, rip off my clothes and roll me whipped cream and night at home with the Hoovers. Oh, man, I can't believe you didn't shoot yourself years ago. Oh, well. What's for dinner? No, Charlie, come on. No. Not the egg salad. Charlie, come on, not the egg salad. No!
And now, there's new longer-lasting Glade Carpet Potpourri. So now, the freshness lasts even longer. Spray it, shake it, or pump it.
No! One stuffy nose, one sore throat, one bad cough, one place to go. The Halls of Medicine, with the vapor action formula of Halls Mentholyptus. Real medicine so you feel better fast. The Halls of Medicine.
Presenting Fresh Mint Gum, the freshest mint.
Kiddly-bop-doo-wop.
The coolest cool. That's quite a package. Fresh Mint from Trident.
Kinder, gentler, no way.
Like a rock, I was strong as I could be. Like a rock, nothing ever got to me.
Chevy S10 pickup, powered by the biggest V6 available. Chevy trucks.
Like a rock,
the trucks you can depend on. The trucks that last.
The moment you never thought you'd see.
I'm leaving home.
Honey, I hope you're not jerking us around again.
Chris moves out on the season premiere of Get a Life next.
I don't know when the last time was you turned on your cable access TV, but every time I flip it on, there's some guy with a juicer on there.
Yeah, I saw one last night, Hair Weaving with Lloyd and Millie.
See, anybody can get a show on cable access. In fact, we'll prove it tomorrow night on Married with Children as Kelly Bundy gets her own talk show.
Stay tuned next. Chris Elliott is back. He's 31 years old. Do you think he's still living with Mom and Dad?
Tonight, he moves out. It's the season premiere of Get a Life next.